Greetings and salutations. Karaca Khan III of the Silver Horde has just ascended the throne, and I think it's time to make him a bloody god of war. It seems the only appropriate thing. Right. He is, I believe, still leading... Yep. Damn right, leading the central charge, the Horde's central charge. We need to rebuild the council entirely. We lack anything even remotely like a capable steward right now. So, on the flip side though, we have... I can contact my liege. There is no liege. It's... Anyway. We'll need to bury my uncle soon enough. But that can wait for the moment. Get a horse arrow, appropriate. See if we can't hire some stewards. No, disappear without a trace, my friend. He'll do. Yeah. Batan, you've got the job. Go and prove Etil, if we're not already building one, new horse breeder. Get us all the advantages we can. Spymaster. Mala. My mother-in-law, hilariously. I want her studying technology with the Byzantines. I need a new diviner. Vakrim, who is the court physician, will do very nicely. And he can research some cultural tech whilst he's at it. Also, he can bloody well see, come and help, you know, the sickness, consumption I've got. Maybe there's no cure. It's going to kill me at some point. Maybe I can achieve victory before it does, though. Also, I could really use the piety as a bonus. So, in celebration of our accession, we'll donate the Lords of the Sky, get a steed named after us, and proceed on this from there. Let's hope that. There are several different types of treatments he can offer. He's skilled, but I don't want to die right off the bat. So let's go for a well-tested treatment. Thank you. Ah! I came into my chambers with earthenware jar cradled in his arms and came to sit by my bed. He pulled a leech from the jar and gave it a most tender look before carefully placing it on your face. Remain still, my lord. Better not disturb their feeding. That is actually quite a successful treatment, as such things go. Lovely. Right, finally, that constituted a bloody significant battle. Right, give. All of that needs to come over now. And then on top of that, my heir is unmarried. Kagan Haravoy, my half-brother. I don't really care about him marrying, but I feel obliged to make it happen. So, yeah, fine. Marry you off to my cousin. It'll do. Oi, I said marry off to my cousin. Make it happen. Get some bonus prestige from it. Oh, we can pick an ambition. Groom and heir. That'll do. Why not? Right. For now, we actually need to... Oh, we need to promote some commanders. That's true. Okay. Who do we have that might suit the job? Karaca, he's the Chancellor. I'm not sure I entirely want him in the field, especially not given that he's wrathful and insane. But for the moment, it'll do. You know, not exactly spoilt for choice. Yeah, he's free to lead an army now. Karaca. I guess I could do with... Probably, first of all, let's see if we can't import any non-ruler gods of war. It's usually worth just taking a quick check. No, we can't. Right, promote commander. We'll have to sacrifice prestige and gold. Yeah, not what I asked for, decidedly. Bizel is... yeah, he'll do. Make him a commander. Let's see if there's anything else. Not what we asked for. Tyrak, a hunter and a holy warrior. And a coward. Not something we want in a bloody commander. Really, because they get such terrible penalties to fight on. Kugel Kugelid. He's aggressive, he's a strategist, and he's a highly capable warrior. Fine. While I'm busy dealing with everything else going to crap, take the lead. Go make the Daman, whatever's going on there. And the Sword of Erlik Khan. What? How did I become the Sword of Erlik Khan? I guess from... probably because I just took over the two significant holy cities and I'm now laying them I'm now burning them to the ground. Ah, I guess that would be why we're the Sword of Erlik Khan. I've got to say, nomads get some goddamn fantastic titles. Like, as... there's... ah, stuff like the Destroyer, the Mutilator, Sword of Erlik Khan, Slayer of the Turk. It's all just desperately satisfying. Yeah, we are actually sacking, and we're sacking Medina, but we've just ordered the Holy of Holies sacked. We're committing some horrendous sacrileges. It's not really necessary to say it, but just in case anyone's a bit concerned, as you would expect, I've really nothing particularly against taking my uncle to the mountains. I have nothing against most major religions, full stop, including Islam, although I will be the first to say that I have issues with certain sects of all manner of faiths and non-faiths. For a good example, a classical historical example, the Borgias, and the Pope Alexander of the time, who was there's such a thing as electing a wicked priest to the papacy in CK2, and that, yeah, that's based off the Borgias. They routinely poisoned people. It's an awful time. But yeah, no, it's all in good fun, you know. Just laying waste to the, and it's more that, frankly, in the 800s, because of the focus on... ooh, a small spear throwing competition would be... could be entertaining. It's a good way to enliven your battle technique. Alright, let's have a contest at court. Oh. On our way, we encounter a lonely hermit. Oh, we'll come along. We always like lonely hermits. They often turn out to be surprisingly capable warriors as well. Everyone's attending the spear competition seems to be having a great time. Oh dear. Except for the hermit I just brought in. Oh. They're partaking in the contest, conversing and laughing together. Perhaps the merriment is a bit too much, as a spear carelessly hurled into the field as someone is still out there, measuring the distance to the previous throw. Oh, there is a hole in him. Well, I mean, I guess I'm not too upset that we didn't take that. Well, my half-brother and heir, at least, no one manages to throw farther than him, so that's nice. Bloody hell. Having spent countless hours swinging our sword, it is clear that our technique is getting better. You now know the essence of every possible strike to utilise in a fight. Excellent. Starting to overcome the personal combat penalties from consumption, which is quite nice, because we're taking some penalties from the anyway. Bloody hell, there's no shortage of marriages and betrothals being offered here, is there? The Khan of Magyar wants to marry my niece. Fine. Everyone wanted to marry my niece. It looks like my vassals more or less have this. I'm willing to offer them a white piece because I don't care about the money and I don't need the prestige. And I just want to be free to continue attacking this next lot here. Alright. Damn us to our seventh grandfather. Settle as feudal. Oh, is there... Apparently there's some areas which stopped being pillaged for a bit. Oh, I think everything stops pillaging when you take over from your your successor. Forgot about that. That's fine. Let's burn it all to the ground. I can pillage Kuwait as well. That's already being pillaged. So yeah, we're good. Oh, right. Feudal. I need that position. Otherwise, strategist can take that. Bizel has that side. Yep, he's a duelist. We're good. Kufa's burned to the ground. And Al-Akbar, such as it is, we can probably single county conquest that. Yeah, we're going to attract the attention of nearly everyone. Because we are 87.5% threatening. Ah, everyone hates us. Ooh. Fine. Well, also, maybe interesting to know, the game has now been going for 100 years. That's quite satisfying to find out. Right. Let's burn down this one horse county and get ready for the next big task. Yeah, the Sultan in Cairo is busy dealing with a decadence revolt. Best of luck to him, old chap. But, I don't rate his chances entirely. Oh, balls, we have allied vassals we can call in there. Recently had the opportunity as part of a succession game on the Bay 12 boards to replay a feudal ruler, and I forgot how different an experience it is. Like, you can't just sweep through the land as the sword of Erlik Khan and ruin all in your path. You actually have to, not with such ease and focus, you've actually got to gather your troops. Strange experience, almost. Anyway. Do these last pillages. Yeah, we could found a merchant republic apparently if we wanted. I think it's because they're specifically coastal provinces. Anywhere left that we haven't pillaged? No. Okay. Ah, we can take the opportunity to worship the ancestors. Fantastic. We got prisoners. You know what? I would ask for a long and healthy life. And I'm willing to provide some pretty entertaining sacrifices for that. We now have Ramadan. Okay, so he's been offered up in sacrifice. I want to bring in the holy orders. Oh, okay, apparently they're already under contract. That's going to be interesting. Anyway, the time has come, the war has said, to think of other things, of ships and shoes and sealing wax. No, sorry. The time has come to have some goddamn impressive population modifier bonuses from the amount of chaos we've caused. But it's also time for us to take on the Mohalabids. Or is it? I mean, we could. Here's the thing. I wasn't going to take on the Mansurids initially because we still had a truce with them, but that truce will now have gone. So we could, if after I surrender a whole bunch of territories, which I should do now whilst I'm talking, we could actually try and take on Baghdad and Kiluk can both go. Lovely. Kiluk, Damascus. Yeah. We could try and just seize Jerusalem. It's not terribly, you know, it's not terribly useful for us to do it. And I guess, you know, I could conceivably keep hold of it for another time. You know, have someone else make that achievement, try and conquer Jerusalem. But then now that I think about it, there's a certain romance in having a later character actually try to settle Jerusalem and rebuild it. Might be worthwhile. We'll think about that. We will. Whilst we're doing this, by the way. Nope. Yes. Okay, so Mon, Hail, Tabuk. Yeah, not gonna have those, is it? Mon, Hail, and Tabuk can afford to go, as can Balk. And for the Pagamans to round it all off, Hill. Okay, it won't show up immediately, but that should now have brought our population down to 75% or more of maximum. Which means we can take Caliph Abu Bakr, and we can declare not a conquest or holy war, but a full-on invasion of Jerusalem. Oh, come on, we still not 45% of maximum? Right, fine. Tabuk still... Okay, so we can still surrender Tabuk. Fine, we'll work this out. Okay, if Tabuk needs going, needs destroying, then Tabuk needs selling as well. We'll shift Tabuk, we'll shift Kiva as well. Kiva, Fergana, well, Kiva and Tabuk is probably going to be enough, actually. I don't have to surrender everything worthwhile. That has got to be enough to put me below 75%. I mean, really, it does. Surely. Surely you can't be... Sorry, no. Invasion of Jerusalem. I've got the prestige, I've got the population, I've got the maximum. Perhaps I need to wait till the end of the month. Let's hope the ancestors do share their blessings upon me. March. Yeah, yeah, bloody right, we're that right. We've got major population decline now. So that'd better bloody well work for us. Declare war, invasion of Jerusalem. Damn right everybody's on board with this. The pragmatists aren't. We've got plenty of glory seekers, so that'll do just fine. Everyone is going to pile on this war. Everyone. I think even our own religious head and holy orders are going to fight against us. We are going to piss off everyone with this war. So let's get to it. And call everyone in for this. We're not yet at the stage where we need mercenaries, but if we did, we could actually hire them now. Like, we're at that point where it might be worthwhile. Let's start raising everything to the ground. Incidentally, with this one, because it's an invasion, I believe the rules are take all occupied territory. Yeah. So we need to, we legitimately need to just occupy the first layer of everything. We don't need to worry too much about all the bits along, you know, every single, conscientious, affectionate, and curious. I think that would be worthwhile. Stewardship, yeah. What was I going to say? Yeah, we need to just take the top tier holding in a, what's the word I'm after? County level holding. Every step for each area in Jerusalem. And it will give us the barony level holdings for free. Bring back the spoils, my lads. So at this point, yeah, we don't need to worry too much about all of the fine details of every single... Ah, the chaos has really starting to set in now. Good. It's the way it should be. Ah, yeah, we are going to lose a lot of territories before this is over. I mean, we're not going to lose them, but we're going to suffer. And you know what? For speed, I've got 29 grand. Let's just bloody well hire two sets of mercenaries. I mean, we'll lose 100 a month, so we could keep going for what, 20 months easily? We're good for a couple of years at full Turkmen level raiders. Right. They aren't in the war against us, are they? Nope. Fantastic. Go via the Byzantines and head down there. We'll take everything away. The horde swarm. Might as well sort that for free. No reason not to. Yep, and we're just gonna raid. We're getting closer and closer to the end of this dynasty, yes, but also just of what has been a quest that has been just a lengthy, bloody, actual quest for me. Right. I'm only continuing with those because the extra gold is useful along the way. It's hardly a major concern. But at the point at which you're, you know, waiting 15 or indeed 20 days to complete construction of siege weapons, You having the opportunity to lose another couple, only waiting a day at a time. Might as well take that one whilst we're here. Yep. Raided. Ascalon. Ascalon. Interesting. As opposed to Ascalon. Very different. In the aforementioned succession game, we're actually playing the Dukes of Ascalon. Or rather, the Orsini. The challenge had been to take the one feudal vassal of the Pope and divide it up so that we were trying expanding the papal estates, which is quite satisfying to do, I have to say. Now this one's a bit weird. We can't just win on points. We have to actually take everything along the way. Unless we want to play the annoying revocation game, which I do not. I have no desire to play the annoying revocation game. My liege, I have a great idea for a monument. Fine, go for it. Hopefully it's a monument of us crushing our foes, because that's what I'm interested in. I keep building all these lovely buildings that are going to get, literally burned to the ground. Okay, I think I'm actually spending so much time on this that it's actually becoming an issue, just watching the various things being raised up and down. I think I might have to change the message settings. Yep, ruin them. If we were a feudal kingdom, it might matter that we're not paying attention to the rest of our empire as it's being picked apart at the sides. We're not a feudal kingdom. Anything worth mentioning in our empire is grass. You could try and burn grass down, but not that effective. Matters of life and death. With age comes wisdom, they say. Or at least it may change the questions we ask, you mutter to yourself. You've had trouble sleeping lately. More often than not, while the rest of your court is sound asleep, you find yourself staring at the ceiling. You're getting older, each day closer to leaving this plane of existence, especially with the consumption. It is folly to fear such things, of course. And you cannot keep these feelings at bay. Didn't you used to dream of grander things? What about you carving your own path? What happened to your ambitions? You should still have them. Yeah. You sit up straight in your bed. This is ridiculous. You are the ruler. You have people to serve your any whim. Perhaps your counselors have ideas. Return to your bed. You haven't tried counting sheep yet. No, we're not getting content. If nothing else, it might ease your trouble sleeping. You summon the council. You summon a secret meeting, invite only. This is a very new event. I've never had this prior before. Also, we have a nephew, Kura. Lovely. You can struggle. A meeting of the minds. Your council convenes, and the faces of your advisors speak of confusion. Why are we here, my lord? It comes with a hint of concern. You sit down and the suspense is almost tangible as you leave the question hanging in the air. Finally, you speak, and without disclosing much of your currently nightly restlessness, you convey the message eloquently enough. I want to discuss the concept of life and death, and I want to look into everlasting life. They nod slowly. So, what do you think? A spirit rises in the room as your counselors start to talk. Some hesitantly, some gesturing wildly. They all have ideas. Perhaps the issue is best resolved by the council. I could trust Marla to handle this directly because of my high intrigue skill. Your spymaster Marla claims to have connections she can't rightly speak of. However, that one raised eyebrow of hers tells me that one of those shadowy figures of the underground might just have the information you need. Send my trusted Karaca. Your translator, Karaca, that Karaca Khan will use his diplomatic ties and send letters to all his confidants. Eternal life is surely something of interest to many a noble, and somebody has to know something. Have Khan Kure organize a search party. Your Marshal Khan Kure will arrange a realm-wide search for any person in possession of knowledge on the matter. He seems doubtful regarding the whole endeavour, but maybe a healthy dose of scepticism is just what the job requires. Kure, I think, has the highest stats, and I have High Marshal as well, so I'm actually inclined to maybe go with him. Organise a search party whilst we're busy raiding. Yep, Mirabelle has fallen. Can't really be asked to... 3 days. Oh, go on. Sometimes I just can't resist raiding raising a city to the ground. There's just so many nice things. Anyway, let's head on to Asuf. Then we can deal with Akka, Tiberius, go down to Al-Mubarak. I've noticed Marshal Khan Kure's hard work, and everyone seems to like him, especially with his efforts trying to hunt down someone who apparently knows the secret to eternal life. Yeah, you can heighten the troops' morale, why not? Come on, assault. Yep, we apparently lost a siege. Bring back the spoils. There might be a siege actually that we were trying to keep. We head down that way. Come on, mouse. You're not that old. You can live through this. The Christmas carol. The Yuletide carol is quite entertaining. There's an element of a familiar Yuletide carol, but with rather more Crusader Kings style lyrics. Home to England's shores and sack of all for gold, or whatever it was. Oh, hello. Someone needs burning to the ground, I can see. Oh, speaking of burning people, how is that lot with their assault? Fantastic. Yep, more ruins, master builders in place. Excellent. Nice to see that the mercenaries are earning some of their keep, if nothing else. Meanwhile, we're just ruining the enemy there. They really should not have even bothered to get up today. Also, whilst we're at Wadi Musa, might as well take the castle. Yep, Asir and Basra are smoking holes in the ground, which will soon produce worthwhile grass for us and our many, many cattle. Like, so many cattle. By this point, we must just have astounding quantities of beef. Right. As much as anything else, it's just trying to keep hold of the areas we've already sieged. Come on, raid, burn it all down. Head on. Yes, 8,000, a worthy fight. This is 9, though. Bring those ones to the ground. Mercenaries are hardly the most effective that we've ever had fight for us, are they? Obviously don't think a lot of their skill and ability. Right. Take out that guy, then that guy, then head to Al-Karak, which I believe is Karak in the other way. Paying your passage. I'm not going to say I believe the stories. I don't know why a Pechenegg Khan has a sort of old-style British English accent, but I cannot with any reliability do an Eastern European, let alone steppe accent, and I'm not going to try. I mean, I am going to try in a different Let's Play, but that's, yeah. So we're just going to go with other voices for this. I'm not going to say I believe the stories, but we have picked up some promising information, my lord, Kura Khan says. However, we could do with some more supplies if we're to journey even further. In fact, I'd like to send word to hire scouts in certain more distant regions if we're to follow the lands and continue this mission. He pauses at the door. Of course, his posture strained. Of course, there are other ways to reach eternity, he sighs. When you open your mouth to respond indignantly, he interrupts you. I suppose the attitude comes with the job, master. My apologies. Your marshal exits the room, his steps growing fainter as you consider your options. Maybe he's right. I'm not a believer either. Fine, I'll spruce up the armory. No, I'll send the world to the... 52 gold? Yeah, I'll send word to the whole world if need be. No worries about spending the money. We have gold coming out of our armpits at this point. We are thoroughly well equipped for this business, for the business at hand. We have no fear. Frankly, it's very interesting time to have gotten, I guess, to have gotten this particular event. Excellent. A track has been swarmed. Track de Moab. Don't really know what that would be, what that's like. Okay. Track de Moab it is. Apparently there's a Zikri uprising going on, which we're just going to casually put down as we pass through. Oh wow, we really hate those mercenaries, don't we? I mean, don't get me wrong, I do hate them. Like, I have no great concern for the lives of mercenaries. I'm certainly happy to murder them all as I pass. Cool. I could become humble. I'm not humble. The monument promised by Batan is finished. Upon unveiling, a statue of yourself is revealed, and you notice the crowd smiling and giving you a round of applause. Batan, I have no words. Mostly because I'm busy killing people. I really hope that statue is built out of the bones of my enemies or something. That would just seem appropriate, you know? 2 days. Fine, we can raid that. Who doesn't love pillage? Let's take Acker, which I think is actually just still Acker. Yep, that hasn't changed. Title hasn't changed a bit. I'm actually not going to risk my life seeking treatment for illness right now. Not when there's another possibility. As I say, this event chain has never come up for me before, so it's an interesting time. Charge down there, take out that, and then that, and then around to that before going up to Sur. It's worth our while to do it. Come on, old chap. Let's not lose an unnecessary battle. My lord, there's a noble warrior at the gate. He says he is a veteran of many battles and desires to become a champion of your house. He praises your wisdom and honour and pledges to always defend you and your household if you'll accept him into your retinue. Okay. I mean, we love noble warriors, so yeah, sure. By all means. Cornell. Court 150. 15. Cornel Cunland. Oh, he's quite good. Strong, skilled tactician. A desirable catch for some. But not perhaps for all. Grab that one, and then we'll come back and head for so, as we have other business to attend to. Those mercenaries aren't really reinforcing quickly, are they? Certainly not for the, you know, for the amount of gold we're paying them. It's honestly a little disappointing. That way. Sorry. Karak, and then Maraba, and then So. Because really, if we don't periodically kill those guys off, it will actually reflect badly on us. There we go. Wadi Musa. When will they arrive? March? That's a fair way away, honestly. Alright, well, we'll kill those people anyway. Honestly, ordinary sieges, that's what we're reduced to down there. Sol, my half-brother, wants to kill my heir. Yeah, stop that. Not entirely on, old chap. Oh, it's getting late. Also, we're fighting the Caliph. It's quite entertaining. We're killing him in person. I do suspect... Wow, apparently that alone is still not enough to push us through to a full victory. Not that it matters, you know, I'm willing to spend the time with this one. If only because of the, you know, sheer amount of occupation we've got to do. I don't know if we can take all of it, like exactly how much invasion is going to happen here, but... A mystic appears. Your martial courier looks lost for words. Master, I'm not sure what to think. He shakes his head as he searches for the correct way to phrase himself. My Khan, she is impressive. I can't quite put my finger on it. Not to mention she has travelled far. His face conveys uncertainty as he shifts his weight. I see, you say, scratching your head. Kura breaks the silence. My lord, I can still send her away. What says you? Now let's hear this woman out. A courtier named Marion appears. Interesting. Let's take a look at the stats of this here Marion. I'm curious. Lowborn Mande. She is a mystic with godlike martial ability. Whoo. Will not marry. For one reason or another, this character will not get married. Yeah, she's brawny, she's scarred. Wrathful, diligent, proud, and brave. I really hope... If we have to duel her, we might die. If only because of the consumption. That's going to be difficult. We can also apparently unlock another technological advance. Of course, it's more cavalry. Ume is my daughter. Lovely. She can be proud. I really she should have been sneaky. Would have been useful. Especially since we can now take relatives as spy mistresses. Ah, no matter. We're pretty much in the end game for the Haravoys anyway. And I'm not too concerned An intriguing encounter. The tall figure offers you a nod, but does not smile. She eyes you skeptically, measuring you up as much as you are her. Her clothing, possibly intended to be modest, is foreign to you, and you have trouble concealing your confusion. In fact, the warrior woman before you is bound to stand out in your court in more ways than one. "I am Mariam. You are Karaca," she says, as if somebody had forgotten to introduce you. "Perhaps you should have spoken the first words to assert your position, but the muscular woman makes you more than a little nervous. "I hear you are looking to live forever," she finally says, more statement than question. "I can help." "Blasphemy in the name of Tengri, imprison this filthy heretic." "Mariam the Fearless." Ooh. That is impressive. "It's outrageous. Leave at once if you want to keep your head." "Yeah, I'm gonna piss off the temples, but everyone in our family pissed off the temples. Yeah, I will accept your teachings, Mariam. Eternal life must be mine." Right, we're a bit wrong on the head, honestly, but right now. Oh dear. Young Perit Nirval, or whatever her name was. Let's keep on looting. Board swarms into Scandalon. Scandalon, the most lascivious among us. Ah, Homs has fallen at last. Glad to hear it. And we want to bar that next. Captain Yolanti is not really doing a great job right now, is he? Oof. Have a couple of loner commanders, as it were. And we will raid the crap out of that holding. Move up north to Beirut. Everything is a little... A serious concern. Kagan joins you after supper one evening. He initiates a conversation about the status of trade in the realm, which is fairly impressive. Yeah, a fairly obvious contrivance given his complete lack of stewardship and the fact that he's slothful and uninterested in business in any way. But you notice that he seems distraught. You interrupt Kagan and demand to know why he's sought you out. "My dearest half-brother, I fear for your life," he says earnestly, earnestly, and seizes your hand. "Who is this sacrilegious heathen you've invited to your court? Her promises are sweet, I am certain, but she cannot be trusted. Please, half-brother, allow me to find out her true motive before it is too late." You know what? We are... We might as well... It won't hurt to have him investigate her. Or will it? She seems a suspect sort. No, let's... Yeah, you know what? I'm paranoid. The family paranoia comes from a good place. She might be planning to sacrifice me in, you know, her own bloody eternal life ritual or something like that. Beirut. Let's go in now. I need to head south and do some chaos management soon. Keep everything still occupied. Also, we're still at 99% due to the difficulty of everyone else bringing enough of an army to actually face me. Ah, which is a hilarious thing. I have to admit, I'm flying genuinely blind with this sequence of events. I've never seen it. Late one night, troubling news. Late one night, there is a knock on the door of your study. You open the door to find Kagan standing there. His eyes dart around nervously as he requests to be let inside. You make a gesture for him to enter and ask him to take a seat. I have some very disturbing news, half-brother, he says as soon as you sit down. It's about Mariam. I've had her followed, and the intelligence my spies have given me is most worrying. He proceeds to tell you about a clandestine meeting Mariam had with a suspicious-looking stranger. According to Kagan, Mariam intends to harm you. I need to know the truth myself. Because the thing is, he's my heir. He has good reason to betray me. I'm just saying, you know? I didn't survive to be the heir to the bloody Silver Horde by being decidedly due to my extreme credence. More pillaging. Every day we're pillaging. Sorry. Nice easy joke. Was it every day we plunder in, I think is the actual quote. Okay. I guess there and then there. Arca would do. The honour of the ancestors. Mariam sits on the floor at the end of the room, what looks like polished pieces of bone strewn out in front of her. She motions for you to join her. You have neglected your spirit, she says, eyes closed. You shift uncomfortably in your seat. I have not, you mumble. Her eyes open at this and she stares at you, a steely cold look, and you retract your statement. You must sacrifice, she declares. Very well, you reply, thinking you'll have your learned Vakrian see to it. As if she could read your mind, Marion shakes her head. You must do this on your own. Do you see what I see? You notice a pattern in the bones. It looks just like an antelope. How curious. A field of crops. Beautiful. A man falling. What do you want from me? An antelope seems the most appropriate for, you know, our, we're not sedentary people. We don't use, raise fields. So yeah, it would be an antelope. The Mystic's Ultimatum. You were just about to knock on the door of Marion's chamber when the door is thrown open. The Mystic's faith is hard as stone and her eyes flash fire. Please. Come inside, master, she says coldly. It has come to my attention that you have had me followed, Mariam says as she closes the door behind you. You try to reply, but she cuts you off. I cannot teach you if you do not have absolute faith in me. Either trust that I am your loyal servant, or send me away. Nothing else will do. I don't want to abandon the quest. Oh no, not trusting. Oh no. I could throw her in the dungeon. I don't have to become trusting. What would he do? He's too ambitious. He's ambitious. He's not proud, but though he is patient. Oh, he's patient, isn't he? Trusting is going to kill my intrigue. Fine. I'm going to regret this, but we're patient. We can always kill her later. Please forgive me. I suppose I must have faith. Trusting isn't strictly speaking a negative trait, I just tend to think it is. Also, we need to go down and start killing some more troops soon. Oh, We're doing all of this while there's a lengthy war for Jerusalem going on. It's quite entertaining in that sense. Okay, Arca. Yep. The Grateful Dead. Mariam hands you a beautiful dagger. The antelope, held down on a stone slab, is surprisingly calm. Thank you, you say quietly to the animal. You hesitate only a second before slicing its throat. The blood pours down the altar, and Mariam nods solemnly. Your heart flutters at the notion of having pleased the statuesque character. Your grandfathers and mothers would be proud, Mariam announces. Hey, we gained some more martial. And brave. Which is good, because we need more martial than she does, I think. Like, I'm not certain, but it seems likely at this point. Okay. Can't be that. No, we're just gonna lose those sieges, I think. That's fine. We can go down, we can crush them, we can take back the land. The difficulty of having to make the whole journey back up here, it's more useful to me, I think, to be able to claim those lands here and now, and then go back to get those territories back once again. Yeah, as you might have guessed, we have supernatural events decidedly on. I think we might also have a couple of other events on that I might not necessarily have intended, but which are definitely going to affect the alternate history of this world. So much. Wait, no, no, 3301, stay. You awake rejuvenated. After some moments of disbelief, you realise that your fever has passed and your appetite has returned. Against all odds, you have survived consumption. Oh, I feel better. My personal combat skill is now 1, 2, 3, 4. We have some impressive combat skills right now. That is excellent. A fun thing to have learned. Oops. Karakakan of Pagaman has finally adopted the revised term for it. It's quite nice to hear. Yeah. It's not really an assault. There's only a handful of people there. Although once we're at it, take that down. Cool. Bastard cousin, who is a timid, willful, ambitious idolizer. He can get a learning education. Not Vakrim. But Vakrim was the best of us. Who will be true? I mean, no. No, I don't think that one's going to be, Yeah, no, we can invent. We can spend some money on priests, some piety on priests, because frankly at this point, I'm not having as my court chaplain... Oh, trusting, that's very desirable. I'm not having as my court chaplain someone who's bloody inclined to kill me, especially if I also then make them my, court physician for the moment, which I will. Huzzah. Right. Moving onwards. Yes, bring me the spoils. And now that that's done. Has it been 3 years? It's been 3 years. Oh, that's how it's lasted so long. Our threat is still astoundingly high. But by and large, we're not doing too badly. Okay. Do we have all of the top tier, top level holdings? Because if we do, that's enough. We don't have Hebron. Okay, that's fine. We'll need to go in and get Hebron. We can do that. That's no problem. Take Al-Karak, get Hebron. Once that's taken, we can then end this war and claim all of Jerusalem and hopefully maybe a bit to the north for our own. We might get any of the stuff to the north. High Priest Togril has died and been succeeded by High Priest Kegan. High Priest Togril was apparently one of my commanders. Oh, because of the holy. Right, because of the holy order, maybe. Not sure. My nephew. Apparently, he's had another heir, which is lovely. He can struggle, same as I did. Okay. Young Aram is an elusive shadow. Don't know who he is, but apparently probably a prisoner. Okay. Quick save. Just in case this all goes to hell. Okay. And then we probably really need a break. I think that's all the top level holdings in that whole area taken. Time for peace. I enforce my demands. I take all occupied territory. You lose 200 prestige. The silver invasion of Jerusalem has ended. Karaca Khan III of the Silver Horde has won. Holy crap, we actually managed to get all of that territory in the end. Yeah, there's a few isolated bits here and there that I didn't really feel like going and hunting, but that's a win. And I think that's also, that really is every single one of them. Madalas, that's an issue. Don't know why Madaba is like that. I'm gonna have to revoke some people for that one, but that's nearly everything. Oh, that is satisfying. Abdul, don't know what your deal is, but I'm revoking your title. Just suck it up and take it. Nothing you can do to stop me. Yep. That too. And that as well. Okay. Right. I'm gonna take a break now. Because that was an achievement. Join us next time for the continuing, hopefully continuing adventures of Karaca Khan, the Sword of Erlik Khan. Fare thee well.